Hello everyone, Luis here. Today I'm going to talk about a very important information in the video of today. It's a follow-up of my latest video talking about the RERF test for Anycubic printers. If you did not watch it, this one, I'm leaving here the link for you guys to check. But basically I'm going to teach you how to create your own RERF test, and with this test you can try to find your perfect settings and your perfect resin exposure to print your beautiful models. Okay, also I'm going to share with you a very interesting feature that I discovered recently on my Photo Mono, and I'm pretty sure very few users know about it, and it's a very useful feature. Okay, so stick with me and I'm going to guide you through all this process. If you are enjoying the content, please consider to subscribe, smash the like button, and also if you have any comments or thoughts, please leave on the section below. So without further ado, let's go to the PC and we continue from there, okay? So we are back here to Lychee Slicer. For the purpose of this presentation, I'm using Lychee for that, okay? So how you are going to create your own RERF, right? Everything starts with a model, right? You need to pick a model to use as your reference, okay, and I'm using the Ameralabs because I like the Ameralabs as a calibration tool. And how the RERF test works, basically it divides your build plate in 8 sections, each section with a different exposure time, okay. It starts in the number 1 here, with the exposure time equal to your normal exposure layer that you define here on your resin, okay? And it goes up to the quadrant 8. And for each quadrant, it increments 0.4 seconds for mono screens and 1 second for RGB screens, okay? If you have a Photon, Photon S or Photon 0, it will increase 1 second for each quadrant. So you are going to find a way to identify each of the models, right? In my case here, I create the 8 different Ameralabs with markers here on the base. I'm not that good on modeling or editing STL, so if you are better than me, you can maybe put proper numbers or anything like that. In my case, I create different models with markers here. I will open the file just that I created before, and here it is. We have 8 files, and you should do exactly how it is here. Okay, in Lychee, when you open it, you have this arrow here showing the front, and the quadrant 1, it's always on the top left corner, okay, and the quadrant 8 is always on the bottom right corner, okay, it's always like that. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, I will load the original file over here. And the original file, as you can see here, it has 1, the top here, and 8 here. Okay, it's exactly as I said. And what's the next step? Next step is to export the file. And in fact, you are going to define the resin exposure that you want. So you come here to your resin and you define here the starting value for your reference. Maybe you can get the standard value and put it down a little bit, like 1 or 1.5. You define that. Let's say that I put 1 here. And you are going to export that file. And you need to export it and use exactly the same name as the original file. It's R underscore E underscore R underscore F. Okay, you need to use exactly this name. You are going to save that on your USB, and now I'm going to show on the printer how that works. We are on the printer now after we prepared and sliced our file. We'll do a ghost print here to show you guys the process and how the file works, okay? So basically, you have the file prepared, the USB in place. You come here, select your test file. See, beautiful. You hit play, and the printer will start. Okay. I'll put a piece of paper here to be easier for you to see. But basically, now we have here our 8 different models that we prepared before. Start with 1 and ending with the 8. And after all the bottom layers finish, the file starts to behave in a different way, showing different exposure times, okay, for each of the quadrant of the build area. Let's do a time warp now to skip the bottom layers, and we are going to the normal layers. So we have now our normal exposure layers, and as you can see, the process is already in place. We have different exposure times for each of the quadrants. It starts with 1 here, 1.4, 1.8, and so forth until reach the 3.8 here on the number 8 quadrant, okay? It's a really, really smart way to test resin, and the good part is that it saves a lot of time from the user, and you can have more time to have fun printing beautiful models instead of tons of test models. And here is an interesting discovery that I made recently with this printer. Let's imagine the scenario where you have your RERF test already here, sliced. And let's say you are going to test as low resin. You know that this resin needs a little bit more time than the regular one. And you slice your file with 1 second, right? So what you do normally, you go there and slice again. Computer brings back here to the printer, right? But with this feature, you do not need to do that. You go to the cog here option, and you can come here and select normal exposure time. Now I want 3 or 2, let's say 2. And I want the bottom exposure time to be 30. I want the exposure off to be 0.5. I want the bottom layer to be 5. And even the speeds you can change. So that's amazing. You can change the settings on the fly. You do not need to go back, reslice a file to print it again, okay? So that's amazing. I believe not everyone knows about this little trick, and I hope it is useful for you guys, okay? So that's it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Hope this information is super useful for you guys to achieve amazing results with your printer, and I'm looking forward to see your beautiful models printed and well calibrated, okay? If you did not subscribe yet, please consider to subscribe to be notified for future content. If you like the video, please smash that like button, and if you have any comments and thoughts, please leave them in the section below. See you next time. Thank you again for watching. Bye.